Recording. Imagine I have two templates. This is template, two class components. This is component one and this is component two. So in the component one, I will be having a template, class and style. In the component two, I will be having the template, class and style. So whatever the style I have written over here in the component one, that style is applicable only to this component one. Believe me, the boundaries are very much limited to this. A Lakshman Rekha, this is called as Lakshman Rekha. You can't access this, or this style won't bind to any other particular element and any other particular component. This is so strict that I'll come back to that. Even its parent component style cannot so not been applied to the child. Are you getting me? In the same way, if I have some properties over here, these properties cannot be accessed to other classes, other components. Guys, do you feel this is an advantage or disadvantage?
Advantage.
How can you say that?
There may not be chances of any conflict or
exactly. Basically, if you have worked on, if you were working worked on jQuery's jQuery plugin in the HTML,
yeah.
One jQuery plugin will definitely disturb other jQuery plugins.
Yes.
Either you have to take all the plugins from one company, or else you have to write your own plugin.
Yes.
And definitely it is not possible, because if it is a very larger scale application, like 100 members are developing a single application, even 10 members are developing one application, definitely one developer cannot tell, I am using this variable, I am using that variable, to other employees. So while they are writing the custom plugins also, there will be a 100% chance to overlap other plugin data. So how to make their own plugin data isolated only to their plugins only, that should not disturb, or that variable should not be accessed or the other? That is only possible with actually isolation of the components or isolation of the plugin. It's too difficult in jQuery, but that concept is a default point in the Angular. Here one component will never disturb other component. It is so difficult. I mean to say, even they are living in a same house, I can't tell my father to give me 100 rupees in my childhood days. I used to say to my mother, "Mummy, I need 100 rupees. Tomorrow we are going to a movie." So mummy used to convey that information to father. Father pehle to gaali dete the. He used to why movies and all. He never tell that to me. Mummy ko milta tha. And finally he gives that 100. That's a different case, but this is a cycle. I mean to say, this is how we communicate. Such a isolation is there. Of course, nowadays parents are different. Okay, but yeah, after my graduation, my father is a different fellow for me. But this has happened in my lifetime. The same way, if component one wants to say something to component two, directly it is not possible. This is so complicated that let me select it. Even this component is inside the other component. even in this case also, this component values cannot be accessed in this component. Okay, so that is what I wanted to show you today, how these components will be communicating with each other. Okay, very big topic, I know. Let me start with a small example. I think it is compiled successfully, thankful to GitHub, because it is making us available with the code. And sorry, localhost colon 4200. I'll show you what exactly I want to display. App parent, okay. In the parent.html, I'm displaying some. Save. Okay, guys, here is my application. Okay. In the left side, I have list of mobile phones. If I click on Oppo F1, it displays the Oppo F1 features over here. If I click on Vivo, I'll get the display of Vivo. If I click on Apple X, I have the display over here. Okay. Please excuse me with my styling. I am very good at that. Okay. But remaining functional level, it is too good. Okay. So now, I want to display like this. Actually, this is the child component which is displayed under parent component. But even the communication between parent to child is very difficult in this regard. Okay. Have you understood what we are going to say? If I click on this particular element, a new component should be displayed over here. In the starting, the component is not available. Only the details are getting displayed. If I click, only then the details of this particular asset should be displayed as a separate component. Maybe in the future, I want to make use of the same component in another place also. That is why I separate the components. Okay, they are called as reusable components. Okay, yeah. Now let us go to that. How can I do that? By using a property binding and a different property binding. Okay, let me delete all of these things. So here I create another component, right click on it, and component, the name of the component is child. So app component is my parent component and child is my child component. So how can I make use of the parent component, child component in parent component? I have to know what is the child component selector name. Copy this and use it inside the parent component. So So the child component is already loaded. But for the sake of simplicity and betterment, I will do one thing. Div id is equal to d1, so that you will feel like which is parent and which is child. Div, you can see h1, this is parent component, and I would like to style it. How can I style it? Sorry, I have to style parent component. CSS, come on, how to style this? Hash d1 border 2px solid, and then background color light steel blue. It's decent. And padding 10px, so you can see some better shape in it. Now the same way I would like to design my child also. Div id is equal to d1, this is h2, this is child of app, and I had to style it. I'll style it hash d1 border is 2px solid, background color light golden yellow, and padding 10px. Chalo. So in the child component, why the child component is not visible over here? The reason is, in the app component, I have not included the child component. So let me include it in this child app component by using its selector. Hope you can see the app component, child component is inside the app component. Am I clear, sir? Okay. So shall I apply any queries? Okay, first thing I want to show you is, I will be having some span and with some value like this, hello manumits.com span, and I will style the span here. Span the span form, I mean to say, font weight is equal to strong. Hota hai kya? Bold hota hai. Yes, sir. And the same way, I have some span inside the child also. Span Manuits Academy. But the style of parent component span is not even getting applied to the child component. Can you see the isolation, the level of isolation? Two isolated, separate. I don't have any relationship between these two. Such an isolation is available, yes, between parent and child. In fact, it is the most beautiful. It is as beautiful as Taj Mahal and Aishwarya Rai. Both are separate.
Yes.
No doubt in it. Okay. Because we had a lot of struggle with this isolation in JavaScript and jQuery. But finally, we had this beautiful feature with AngularJS and Angular. Why we become mad about one technology? Because that feature is waited for a long time. We were waiting a series win in the England for a long time. We couldn't get it. But when we get it, we feel like, yes, we achieved it. Okay, we got it. In fact, achieved, we didn't achieve it. Okay, come again. So this is how the app component is, two components are working. Now, what do I do is, but still I want to pass some data from app component to the child component. How can I pass it? Yeah, first of all, let me take the component data. I have Rasika in the first component, I mean app component. I want to bind this data to child component. To bind the data to the child component, I definitely need a property, at least f name. I have a property. If I have a property, I can bind it. But how? Yeah. So first thing is, I had to make this property as input property. And that means this property is inputable property. Parent to child input. We can give the parent to child input. So if I want to make this property as an inputable property, I'll make it like this. First, I had to import the input no definition at all. I will come input decorator. In fact, it is a decorator. So input decorator makes a property as an input property. So this is an input. Declares a data bound input property. Angular automatically updates data binding bound property during the change detection. Don't worry. Input takes an optional parameter that, okay, leave this. I have explained you better. So this f name is now an input property. If you have an input property, what is a normal property? Come on. L name is a normal property. This is an input property. If you have an input property, I can bind some data to this input property from the parent. How? Like this. In the HTML, within the component itself, I can bind it like this. I have a property called fname. Can you see now fname is also coming into the property list? Fname is equal to what I want to bind? First name. So input properties can be binded with the element detection. Element, as soon as you included the element, in the element itself, you can use this property. These are all inputable properties. So now I can access, can I access it now? This first f name can be accessed in my template? Of course, yes, sir. You can. Shall we see this? So the parent component data is now with child component. Guys, you understood this point?
Yes, sir.
So I have created an input property, input type property in the child class, and I am binding from parent to child. Whatever you want to pass, you can pass it over this. For example, what I'll do is, I'll create an input element over here. and I will bind a template variable here. I bind a template variable over here. Okay, so whatever I type, I can actually pass the value to this input property. Can I pass the value here directly by using fn dot value? So if I have manumits dot com, of course it is not showing you because what was the reason? Because I have not binded any event over here. Key up
event.
We need to do this obviously. So the data is getting passed to child by using input property binding. Is it okay? Am I clear, sir? Please practice this input property binding because this is the only way to bind the properties from parent to child.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So okay. This isolation makes, if someone is intentionally doing it, that only then it will be binded. So they know there is a variable of this sort. So only then it will be binded. Okay. The isolation is such a beautiful isolation, and you can see this. I have two app childs. I have two app childs, and in one case I am binding with fname, in another case I am not binding with anything. That doesn't mean it will be updated in both the childs. This child is different and this child is different. Can you understand, sir, how amazing it is? So in which particular element you want to bind, you bind it. If you don't want to bind it, don't bind it. Then there is no input at all. Such an isolation will be observed in the input property. So this is one thing is over. Now the next thing is, how do we send the data from child to parent? It is little tricky. For this, we are using a concept called event binding. Okay. We create an event and we emit an event from the child. And we handle that event in the parent. Okay. I know you have yet to be happy. I mean, had to be so comfortable in the input property, but yes, please repeatedly watch this video and you'll understand it definitely. So for this, I'm using an output property in the child. So from here, I want to emit the value, right? Here, I will emit the event, and then that event should be captured or handled at parent. Is it okay? So for that, I would like to draw the diagram. Control all delete. This is the parent component. And this is the child component. So the parent component should receive the data. So for that, what do I do? I'll emit event, and here I will first bind the event and handle it. Okay, so that is how it will happen. So first it will be emitted, and we are here in the parent, I am going to handle it. So let us see how I am going to do it. So in the child, I have some data. That is, the data is location. As I told you, if you want to emit a value, if you want to emit a property, you have to make it as output property. Just like input property, you have also, you had to import output decorator. Only then a property can become an output property. So at the rate output like this. Capital O. Please make sure this brackets, this is a function actually we call output decorator. This is a syntax. Okay, you will get it later. But now location is what? An output property. Is it okay? Okay, but this is outputable property, but I had to emit this property, right? So should I create an output property or output event? In fact, I had to create an event, not just the property. So the value will be passed through that. I'll come back to this. So I will create an element called get location. Get location is an output event. To create an output event, we had to make it as event emitter. This syntax is little tricky, so here I would like to write it as event emitter. So here I am actually creating an event emitter, not just the property. I'm creating an event emitter. The name is, the event emitter name is get location. Okay, so this get location event should be emitted. How can I emit this event? Okay, that is possible only at the time of button click. I will tell you all these reasons after some time, not at this moment, but please follow me. I'll create a button. This button is send location. When I click on this button, I will call a function. The function name is send location. So this send location function should be defined here. Now, as usual, of course, send location function. So when I click on this button, the send location function will be called. In this function, I can emit it. Emit that get location event. This dot get location dot emit. So what does it emit? It will emit the location here. So it is able to emit a value. So this emit, I mean, when I click on it, it is already emitted the value. But now my parent should capture it. Okay. So where should I capture it? If the event is of child component, I will capture at the child element itself. That means here in the app child, I will handle it like this. Which element I'm event I'm emitting? Get location element is equal to, I will call another function. Okay, the function name is lock some function. I don't have the function yet. So when this get location event gets emitted, this lock function will be called. Okay, shall we see this lock function will be called or not? Where should I define this lock function? In the parent component, no? Because I am handling in the parent component. Ultimately, I want the data in the parent component. Simply, I'll just alert. Okay. Get location event raised. Okay, let us see this. If I click on get location, I got an alert. That means get location means this lock function, this parent component function is getting called. From child component, I am able to call a parent component function. Not only that, I am also able to pass some values also. Okay, to capture that values, we have to pass those all values in dollar event. So all the values whatever coming from the child are captured in the dollar event object. Okay, that is available in the dollar event, and you can see them, you can see that. So here I can have E, and I'll tell you E. What did he say? Okay, alert is not having. Send location, get location event raised, and beside that there is walk card. So parent to child to parent, the data is getting emitted. I have already captured in the function. I just now I need to put that value into some variable. Shall we put it in some name? No, because I am not using it. So how can I make use of it? Already E is having the value. So I create a variable called location is equal to, sorry, location, and I'll update this E into location. How? This dot location is equal to E. So can I make use of this location in my component? So from child, I am able to update it in the parent. Guys, is it fine? At least see how you may not understand the syntax, but how do we pass the parent component to the child component? By using input property binding. How do you pass the data from child component to the parent component? By using
output
event emission. Okay, so by using this, I am expecting some outcome like this. Maybe you are not able to do it immediately, but I will implement the same feature tomorrow in our class. Okay, but today you have to try this job. Okay, shall we conclude for today? That's it for today. Please have a nice time. Please practice today itself. This is one of the most complicated topics.